Welcome back. This is Muhammad Harun Idris, Mobile Electronic Diagnostic and Best Car Fixes. Today we have a subject I am about to show you concerning the accelerator pedal. In the car, there is a time where we have a cable or a mechanical accelerator pedal, which means that when you push the brake, when you push this pedal here, there is a cable, actually like a cable somewhere here. It go all the way to the throttle body and it will open the throttle body based on how much force you push into the accelerator pedal. And that one is from the beginning of the car manufacturing. We come down towards recently with the computer technology innovation and all this, most of the new car, they get rid of that accelerator mechanical one and they change it with electronic accelerator pedal or electrical. Why we say electrical? There is no more cable or mechanicals. Even the throttle body itself, the flip, it no more work with manual way. That means you send signal from this pedal here all the way to the engine computer, and the engine computer will take that information, translate it to another information and actuation, where it sends signal to the throttle body, which is also electronic. The throttle body will open based on the demand from this small piece you see here. Okay, this is one. The second thing is we have accelerator pedal position sensor here, and also we have a throttle body position sensor. And most of the time when the people get caught, they confuse between throttle body position sensor, TPS sensors, and accelerator sensors. Most of the time the throttle body position, the throttle sensor, throttle body sensor is like code P0121, 122, or 21, you know, like P2167 or 21, something like that, or 2126 or something like that, around that. It's a throttle body position sensor. When you have that problem, don't change this one. Change the throttle body or clean it or look around those code. Unique code or some code that come to this one, like P2138. If we have 2138 and it's an accelerator pedal position sensor, try to look at the wire here. It have 6 wire. If you wash this car, you do a shampoo and any water or humidity like this here get into it, it may create a signal also, false information. So try to distinguish between the throttle body position sensor and accelerator sensor. If you're getting P2138, look at the continuity of the wire between this one and the engine computer under the chassis. Be sure that you have 5-volt reference 2 and 2 ground and 2 5-volt reference back. This one here, it have 2 sensor reading differently. One is from 1 to 5 and one is from 5 down. They must send the signal correctly to the engine computer. This one is mounted. This is the accelerator pedal. You push the gas and you accelerate. So this is one of the information I'm trying to give it to you. Now, is this one here work for what car? It depends from manufacturer to manufacturer. This one here, it can work for 2007, 2008 Acadia with 3.6 liter. I'm talking about the engine 3.6 liter. Also, Saturn, it will work for Saturn also, from 2009 to 2010, Saturn Outlook. Okay, also it worked for Buick 2008, Buick Enclave. Also 2009 to 2017, Chevy Travers. Okay, look at those, and also 2017 also, one of those, I believe Buick also. Just be sure that this part number here, Nancy, I don't know if it's clear, Nancy PN part number 840-249-26. But before you change the part, be sure that you have look at all the possibility and the code, clear them, let them come back, note them, be sure that it come back and it's related to this one. Do not just go and change it. This one here has been, we have a code for accelerator paddle position sensor. We change it and everything look okay. This one doesn't work anymore. If I have tools, I can open it and see how it look like. But most of the time, it's supported by three screw to the body of the car. And then this is the sensor. It's a small sensor here. I don't know how we can take it. Look like they riveted in. Okay, if they riveted in, it's only electronic, believe me. See, let me try to take this one out. I'm gonna break them and see how it look like. As I tell you, it's just resistor. When you push this one, you change the value of resistor. The computer take that one. This one is going to junkyard, so it's no more anymore. I just want to open it to show you how it look and what is inside there. Okay. Also, the same thing apply to the brake. If you have a brake pedal, also the same one. It have a small sensor mounted into it. Just my advice for you. On the brake, when you have somebody stand in front of you or stop in front of you, suddenly somebody stop in front of you and you have a brake, do not stand and push the brake hard. Brake, no, it will not work. You're going to bend this piece and you messed up your system. So this thing here, no matter what, it's not going to exceed this piece, you see? Even the brake, this is accelerator pedal, but the brake, I don't have any brake module, but brake also work with the same theory. That means this is a plastic and it's sitting like this. The problem, if you push the brake like, hey, the car doesn't want to start, let me push the brake hard, you stand up and you push the brake, gone. The brake divert, it bent. Now the parking brake in the back or the brake light in the back is stuck on continually, and if you drive that way on the highway, as soon as you reach 40 mile, the ABS think that because already this one bent and the brake light in the back is on, you cannot exceed 40 mile an hour with the brake light on, that because the computer think that you are in a highway and you are 60 mile an hour and you push the brake, so it will try to activate the ABS light and it will go left and right and it make you into trouble. Do not push those things more than what you see. You have a check engine light, car goes into a lim mode, park the car, go look for some diagnosis. Here, this is the sensor I just break it out. We have 1, 2, 3. Let me get that tool, if I can get it here. I will open it right now. Also, I like this. By the way, if you are a mechanic or you have, or you are a car owner, please get this. Why I say that? I don't know where I get it, but believe me, write this one and Google it. You see what happened? Push here. Yes. You have all what you need. And then it is good. And instead of, oh, I don't have a screwdriver, I need a flip, I need this. It will help you. What I like about it, this one will not come out unless you have to push this one down. So I'm going to push it. Okay. Put this one back. Yeah. Push back here. It will not come out if you don't push the security belt or mechanical clip here. So this one, if you go in here, it will not come out easy. Let me click it. You see, never come out. Okay, so now the whole unit that your car run with, all those car, as I say, believe me, it's run only with this piece. I'm not telling you to fix it. It's not expensive. If you have a car and you want to be safe, don't try to go and say, you know what, let me clean it, let me do this, let me do that. I'm just taking it piece by piece to give you the idea. Also, oh, I want to shampoo my car. Go in there, put water here, and it will tell you what's going on. Okay, it will show you crazy stuff there. I don't know if this is the way it is or, okay, I see something here. I don't know if this is the one that also making it happen. I'm going to try to move them. If it's not, I'm not saying that go ahead and try to. And you see here, this is the, when this is here and this move, you see, is reading this. And by the way, imagine that those sensors, the way it work, if there's any dirt or anything, it can. And I see even some of the pin broke. You see this side here? You see this side here? You see this side here? It broke. And this customer here changed, the owner, the mechanic changed it. He said, I have a quote. But even if you open it, there is no way, you know, like say, I'm going to fix it. I believe this one have to come out because the center here is built with this one. This have to come out. But if you notice here, this is a problem of it. If you see the one on the top, it's complete. But the one in the bottom, they already messed up. You drive just because of this value, it put the whole car in a limp mode. You drive in the highway and nothing work for you. By the way, this thing here is work for almost a lot of cars, even Chevy Travers 2009 to 2017, Buick Enclave 2008, you know, like Acadia, a lot of cars. So just have it, you have it in your brain that if you're driving one of those cars, with this particular part number, you may have to change it. I'm talking about this, if this is one of your car. But if not your car also, it doesn't matter whether it's a Chevy Venture, Chevy small car. The theory is one. The six wire, they're always there. And they work with it. The whole body here, the rest of the stuff here, you see, have nothing to do with... you have nothing to do with what? With the sensor. All the other body is just something, just a... I'm going to try to go up with it. By the way, this thing coming complete. So you see the whole piece here is just to move the sensor. The whole piece here have nothing to, it's a plastic. Before it was metal with a cable. And I'm sure they save a lot of money by doing this for you. Okay, and they sell it for you. So here is the piece you see here. By the time this tiny thing here is going in, out, calculation. That means the more they come here, the value of the information changed to the computer. Computer, based on this information, computer will send signal and he said, you know what? Let me close the throttle body. Let me open it and look at it here. Look here. This one already messed up. Yes, technology. Past, present, and the future. The future, you may not even need any mechanical signal. It go by wireless. And it already happened in some BMW. Yes. The oil pressure sensor is wireless. It sends signal to the engine computer and it tells that the oil is this or this. That means if you change that sensor, if the sensor is defect and you change it and you put it inside the car, it still will send wrong signal to your car telling that the oil sensor is bad and it will turn the check engine light on. Be careful on that also in the future. Always diagnose the car. Do not assume what happened or somebody did that, he changed that, it will not work. It will not work. So this is what I'm seeing here. This is the sensor, accelerator pedal position sensor for all GM. What I mentioned today, and it could be more, it could be less. Thank you for watching Mobile Electronic Diagnostic. Please share, subscribe, and also like. And if you like our video, please let us know. And if you need more information about some item that are not clear for you, or you need some information about your car, electronical, electrical, mechanicals, that means anything related to electric, electronic, and electric, I will be happy to help you. By the way, the code P0121-221-2176 or something like that have nothing to do with this. This one here, that one may be the throttle body wiring, clean them, relearn them. This one here, look for at least P2138. Thank you for watching Mobile Electronic Diagnostic and see you in another video. By the way, I write some of those information in the paper here as my research. This is a new for this car, for those cars, when you have those code P02138, this accelerator pedal position sensor, the code that is here, I mean the number that is here for the new part number. So if you are thinking that this is your problem, if get this one with a new part number, 84024926. 2138, this is a code. If you have those code here, P2167, 221, P0121, maybe have to do with the throttle body. We're going to talk about throttle body one day. Those car, Saturn, Outlook, 09 to 010. Acadia, 2007, 2008 Acadia. Okay. Okay. Also, 2008 Buick, you know, Buick Enclave, 2008, 2009, 2017, Chevy Travers. Also, Enclave 2017, it will work on that too. The last thing I'm trying to say is that, what car is that again? Those cars, or your car, must be 3.6 lira. Those cars, they have 3.6 lira. That's why the accelerator, the signal, the information are the same. Thank you for watching Mobile Electronic Diagnostic. This is Muhammad Harun Idris, and see you in another video.